Storyboard Pro allows us to make camera moves in 3D. But in order to do that, we first need to convert our scenes from 2D into 3D. And we do that by going up to our toolbars along the top to the Storyboard toolbar. If yours is not showing, just right-click in any gray area and make sure Storyboard is checked off. And you'll see a little icon that says 3D. If you click that, that will convert all of our layers into a 3D space. And you may have noticed that the transform tool also is giving us additional manipulators, allowing us to push and pull it in 3D space. It is also helpful to have our top view showing. If yours is not showing, click the little plus here and go down to top view. So this cone here is representing the field of view of the camera, and this little dot right here is the camera itself. This line right here is our zero position. We are looking down on essentially a two-dimensional flat plane. It has no depth. However, we can give it some space between the layers in order to create some parallax. So we do that first by, let's click on our cloud layer and make sure our transform is selected. We can constrain any of the movements by clicking on a particular value. So here I'll push the clouds back into space and you'll see them shrinking off into the distance. And I'll go into my camera view and scale them back up. I'm holding down shift to constrain my scale and I'll place them like so. Looks good. Let's take the next layer, our background layer, which will be these three little trees and this one and that gray, those grayish hills in the distance. We'll push that back as well into space. And the same thing, we'll scale it back up. Find where it was and we'll just pull that down a little bit. Maybe it's a little too big. There we go, it looks pretty good. And we have finally have these foreground elements, these bushes. Let's pull them close to the camera and pull them up so we can actually see them. Maybe shrink them down a little bit. There they are. There they are, like so. Again, if we walk over to the stage view, we can see the stage view giving us a fixed point of our scene. Whereas the camera view is showing us what the camera sees. So now we have a pretty rough setup here in 3D. Let's add our camera view. Let's add our camera animation, pardon me. And again, we went over this previously in another video, but we add keyframes by clicking down here in our timeline along the camera. And we just hit the little plus sign to add a keyframe. And we'll just go to the end of this and add another keyframe by adding the little plus. And now we manipulate the camera, not with the transform tool, but with the camera. And we can do it either, We can just select the camera and you'll see its manipulator pop up in the top view. And we'll just constrain it in Z and just push on through like that, maybe something like this. And when we play it back, we have some nice amount of perspective and space added in thanks to our 3D scene. Okay, looks good. So let's talk about a few options we can do to help get some of our layers to maybe play a little more nicely with the camera. So we can do that by going up to our layers view. If your layers view is not showing, again, hold the plus, go down to layers to show it. And it's very similar to our little dock right here of our layers, but it gives us a few extra options. You'll see layer alignment. So the first one is no alignment. In other words, the layer is not aligned and the camera can be moved freely and the layer will exist as it does in space. Let me take the camera here and just for our next example, let me just turn the camera a little bit. Let's just rotate the camera, maybe move it over a little bit like this. Just give it a little bit of rotation just to help give us a little bit more understanding of the next options here. Let's click on our character layer. And each layer is independent, so they can have their own layer alignment. But let's just pay attention to our characters for right now. Turning them on and off, that's those guys right there. They are separate. The next option will be to face the camera. So if I click that, you'll see that no matter what the camera does, they will always look at the camera. So let's move the camera a little more to help illustrate that. If I rotate the camera around, the characters layer will always be facing our camera, no matter wherever we place the camera. So that will obviously lead to some clipping. And as you can see, this line right here in our top view is our character layer. So as I rotate it around, you'll see that it is always facing wherever our camera looks. And of course, that will lead to some clipping issues. Let's look at our next option. We select our character layer once again. And the next one is pin to the camera. It's going to align the camera plane and follow the camera wherever it is moved. So when I click that, you'll see that our characters have changed position. Let's go back to our top view again. And so now, wherever I move the camera, the characters are going to follow along with it, no matter where I put it. So if we need some element within our scene, some sort of 3D scene, it could be, oh, I don't know, maybe a camera is going through a cave and we have a bat that we're following, or some sort of winged creature, and the camera's flying through the cave with this winged creature. We could use pin to camera to help keep our character within view. And so those are some ways of setting up a very simple 3D camera move in Storyboard Pro.